stigma, going back, it's one of the signs about how difficult and twisted is the sexual violence whole thing. So you've been attacked, you've been raped, and on top of that, you feel guilty for it, and you don't want to recognize it.
We had this patient that now is 22 years old. She was raped several times since she was a girl. Of course, she didn't receive any medical or psychological treatment. After several years being a victim of sexual violence, she decided to leave her house because the perpetrator was a relative. So she went out of her house to look for a safe place, but when she arrived to this safe place, she was feeling alone and she started abusing alcohol. She attempted to commit suicide twice. She never received any kind of support. And the third time, she has to be admitted at the hospital because the medical consequences of what she took to kill herself were devastating. So if this person had received medical and psychological treatment since the very first time, we will not have these consequences.
I think we hold a lot of judgment around rape. I think we hold a lot of silence around rape. It's not something that we talk about very often in our own homes, in our own communities, with our own friends. So then imagining being in a foreign country where the stigma is even greater, or where the risk to the survivor is much greater, that guard at the gate probably knows you, and maybe you're in a space, certainly South Sudan is one of them, where if you are raped and the community finds out, you marry the perpetrator.
One challenge is that we work in hospitals and clinics that are very, very busy. I've worked in maternity hospitals, and in the case of South Sudan, there were 500 deliveries a month. That is a big, busy maternity. And we had one small room that was used to see women who had experienced sexual violence. But in order to get to that small room, the woman would need to get past the guard. She would have to make up a story about why she was at the hospital. Maybe her child was there, maybe she was there for antenatal care, but certainly she wouldn't tell the guard that she had experienced sexual violence. So that was her first obstacle, and this is in a welcoming place.
Can I interrupt and say, why wouldn't she tell the guard?
Because the guards are all men, and also because of the embarrassment of having had this happen to her.